Good morning and Merry Christmas to you all. I am so blessed this morning to be leading worship with Bonnie and Nisa Tolfsted, who are sharing their musical gifts with us. Welcome to our Lessons and Carol service, where we will travel together from Genesis through John and hear the story of salvation and God's love for the world as we intersperse some favorite Christmas carols. So I welcome you to sing along today, and we begin together with our call to worship, which is Psalm 96. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord and bless God's name. Tell the good news of salvation from day to day. Declare God's glory among the nations, God's marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Let the heavens be glad and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and all those who live in it. Let the whole creation sing for joy at the presence of God who is coming. God is coming indeed to judge the earth with righteousness and the peoples with equity and truth. Praise the Lord. First lesson from Genesis, the third chapter. Adam and Eve heard the sound of the Lord walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." And to the man he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife and have eaten of the tree about which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread until you return to the ground. For out of it you were taken. You are dust, and to dust you shall return."
Silence.
Our second lesson from Genesis chapter 22. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice." From the prophet Isaiah, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this." Again, we hear from the prophet Isaiah, "A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. The wolf shall lie down with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together. And a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like an ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea." fifth lesson today is from the Gospel of Luke, the first chapter. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Gospel writer Luke continues in the second chapter. "In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn." There were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. "This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. Lesson today is from the Gospel of Matthew, the second chapter. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. This morning, a lesson from the Gospel of John, the first chapter. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or the will of the flesh or the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Before our Lord in prayer, and I invite you to put in the comment section of Facebook or YouTube things that are on your heart today that we could pray with you as we read those comments during the course of the week ahead. So, trusting in the abundant grace of our God, we pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Loving God, your Son, Jesus, shine light into a dark, dying world. Shine your light on us and make us beacons of light for the world so that all may know you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let all creation sing the praises of a baby king. Let us praise the king with our whole hearts and nurture the creation the king came to save. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let all those in power today lay down their arms and celebrate peace with the knowledge that true power belongs to Christ alone. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heal the bodies, minds, and spirits of all who suffer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Whisper your greatness in the ears of all who have not heard yet, so that the sound of your greatness may grow in shouts of hallelujah. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let the miracle of the newborn king overcome all suffering. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With all the saints, we praise your name and offer thanks for the gift of a baby king. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With faith and hope, we pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us, using the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now is a time we would traditionally take our morning offering, and I would like to thank you all for your abundance and generosity that you're sharing. that helps with the ministries here at Holmen Lutheran Church, from the caring tree to trick-or-treat to prayer shawls to all the different ways that you give of your time, talents, and treasures. We thank you, especially during this Advent and Christmas season. If you would like to contribute to the ministries here, you can do that with the drop box outside of our circle drive, also through our website and Facebook pages. So again, thank you. Let us pray a prayer of thanks to God who provides us with this generosity that we can share. Let us pray. O God of justice and love, we give thanks to you that you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need. Awaken us to the needs of others. And at the end, bring all the world to your feast. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Our closing hymn today, which we will sing together, is Good Christian Friends Rejoice. The God of all grace bless you now and forever. Amen. Go in peace. Share the good news. Thanks be to God. Merry Christmas, everyone.